Hi students, so now I'm doing my introduction page. So how do I do that? How do I begin this second part of the assignment? It says title page and page one, introduction. Well, if I did a project proposal, the introduction is where you combine step one and step two in a page format. A paragraph. So instead of having these bullet points here, I'm going to go ahead and create this entire step one into a paragraph. I'm going to flesh it out a little bit. Now, if you're like many of our students who are just not writers, they're like, oh gosh, now I got to write something. You should think of it in small little chunks. So if I go here, and I go ahead and write my introduction page. This is an introduction page sample. So what I need to do is make sure this matches all of my criteria. So I'm going to change it to New Times Roman. This is what I do in the beginning. Change this. You always want to put your name here, right? You can put student name. Because it means your teacher will get maybe multiple reports, and if they all say introduction page sample, he doesn't know if it's, you know, Brian's, Richard's. He doesn't know who that is. So he can put that there. New Times Roman, you're going to make it 12 font. You're going to go to format, line spacing, and I'm going to make sure it's double spaced. Okay. And then I would put introduction here. Okay. Make sure. Introduction. It's a header. Now, some people like to put this in the center. That's fine. It's fine. Doesn't matter either way. You can do it either way. Left align or center. Okay. So I'm going to enter. And when I hit enter, it will automatically double space it for me. I don't have to go back through and double space and enter every time. If I set it up from the beginning, it's very clean. The computer's working for me instead of me working harder, right? So I'm going to tab over once to create a paragraph line. And I'm going to remind myself of my project proposal, what I want to focus on. So what some people like to do is start with a quote. So I can start with a quote if I'm looking for quotes about tagging. Now, some people think that art, tagging is art, you know, tagging or graffiti, angry graffiti, a political statement, angry graffiti. So if I don't find it in one kind of a search, I go ahead and try to find it using another, right, where they're writing things, I'm very angry, free art, graffiti, that kind of stuff. And so I'm looking for quotes about graffiti. Might be really interesting to start. It's interesting. This is graffiti, but it's graffiti as art. So if you see some kind of like things that we don't like to see. Some kind of violent graffiti. If graffiti is art and art is a crime, then how come Picasso never done time? It's great, right? So you can choose these kind of quotes, right? We can copy and put it in our introduction. So if I paste it, if you notice what I just did there, I went ahead and I highlighted it by dragging the mouse, and then I did Control C, and then I put it in my introduction as Control B. If you notice, this font is different from this font. And since I took it from a website, it changed the size of the font. Now I need to adjust for that. I'm going to put a quote around it. And I'm going to go ahead and open up another page and cite the source. So when I go to this source and I see that this person is the one who said it, Bansky, right? This is a quote from Bansky. And I'm going to go ahead and highlight this as my source, copy. And I need to start to do a reference page. Somewhere in your project is doing a works cited or a reference page. And that's another video. But what I like to do is if I'm grabbing quotes for my introduction page, I'm going to go ahead, open up a new document. And I'm going to paste that source here. Enter, enter, enter. There we go. And I'm going to call it reference page. Because I didn't say it, right? I didn't say it. I took it from the internet. So anything I take from the internet, I have to cite the source. If I don't do that, it's called plagiarism. And you don't want to do that in work, in school. You don't want to do that. You always want to cite your source. So references or works cited page, sometimes when you're quoting someone else, I need to cite that. If I use a quote from Barack Obama or Maya Angelou or Frederick Douglass, I always want to cite that source, even though it's well known. Like, I have a dream. Everyone knows that's Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. But we should cite the source. I mean, I could personally have a dream too, but you still have to cite it, right? So then I go to my introduction, and this is going to be how I talk about it, right? So you can see that the color has changed a bit too. I'm going to go ahead and make sure that it's 12. And I'm going to make sure this is in black. I don't want it to be a different color. And there's no real reason that it needs to be underlined, okay? So I could take that. It's a link to that particular website, so I could leave that alone. Graffiti is one of the few tools you have if you have almost nothing. Even if you don't come up with a picture to cure the world poverty, you can make someone smile while they're having a piss, going to the bathroom, right? Outside, underneath the overpass, like we were talking about. Bansky's quote, and I'm going to go ahead and take this underline out, suggests that art can change your mood. Great. Okay. And then I go back to my proposal and I say, oh, there's tagging on the BART, sometimes has swear words, the city looks dirty. So we're suggesting that the art we see in San Jose is not nice art. It's not beautiful graffiti. It's not a mural. It doesn't have a message. The message is usually like, Luce was here, or where to find good drugs. It's not good stuff, right? So we want to change that messaging to a positive message. So that's what I write, right? In San Jose today, people can see. Sometimes when you're just writing, you can just get the ideas down on the page, especially if you're typing it and not handwriting it. You can go ahead. If you are somebody who likes to talk and get your words on the page, there's something called an audio tool here, which means that you can actually speak voice typing if you're someone who's not fast. So it'll say, click to speak. That, see? The painting under the city overpass is very dirty. Sometimes there is swear words and bad language and gang messaging. This can be very, very bad for children and negative for the city. So you can see that I can pause it. See? So if you're someone who just likes to talk and get the words down on the page, that's easy because we can go back and we can edit easily. In San Jose today, people can see the painting under the city overpass. It's very dirty. And sometimes there are swear words and bad language. Sometimes there is gang messaging, right? We can put it in quotes, maybe. This can be very, very bad for children. Period. Okay. The city, oops. The city can benefit from new positive messaging murals. Every day, it would be different if you could see a beautiful picture instead of hate language. We all agree, right? Yeah. Anywhere there's a red line, I use something called Grammarly, and it does the editing for me. Yeah. In my project, right? My project suggests ways to do this. Yeah. So already I have my first paragraph, and I didn't even talk about step two yet of what I really want to do, right? So I could profile, I can either choose a quote. Whenever I'm having a tough time starting something, I go searching for the quotes from someone else who's done this before. So there are many more humans who have lived before us. Some of them very prolific, and we can, they've all had this idea about making their city look positive and be happy. So if you're struggling on your introduction page, use a quote. And so you just carry on writing your introduction, and that's one page. This is one assignment. If you're someone who's like, let me just get my ideas out there, I want to talk my way through it. Go ahead and use this tool. Okay, it's called Speaking. And you go here, and it's something called Tools Voice Typing. It's really, really useful. Okay, hope it helps.